Yes, well, Senator, we're happy to report na ano, yung reproduction number bumaba na siya. It's 0.93 ngayon.
0.93.
So less than 1 siya, 0.93 siya.
Okay.
And then yung number of cases sa NCR bumababa siya. Right now, we're seeing an average of mga 3,800 cases per day. Bumaba siya ng 20% compared to the previous week. So bumaba, may one-week growth rate siya na negative 20%. And sana patuloy-tuloy na ito, Senator, kasi malaking nababawas yan sa number of cases per day pag bumababa siya ng 20%. And right now, last week kasi nakita natin may mga LGUs pa na tumataas yung cases. Right now, lahat ng LGUs sa NCR may negative one-week growth rate. Pero ganun pa man, medyo unstable pa yung trend. Yung iba, mababa pa yung pagbaba niya. I mean, hindi pa ganun kabilis mag-decrease yung number of cases. And we're hoping maging stable pa yung trend sa pagbaba ng cases.
Paki-clarify nyo nga, Dr. Guido, pagka sinabi natin na the number of cases and the positivity rate, paki-correlate nyo nga yung dalawang konsepto nito, yung positivity rate at saka yung reproduction number. Hindi po ba yung positivity rate ay ang basis nito ay yung test na ginawa sa isang lugar?
Tama yan, Senator. Yung positivity rate, yan yung ng kunyari may 100 tests na na-conduct sa isang lugar. And then kung ilan yung nag-positive doon, let's say 20 per 100, 20% yung positivity rate natin. Sa ngayon, actually, bumaba na rin yung positivity rate natin. Nasa 19% na lang. 3 weeks ago, nasa 25%. Napakataas na 25%. So yung pag bumababa yung positivity rate, ito yung isa sa mga strongest indicators natin na nag-improve tayo. Yung trend natin ay bumababa din. So this confirms, kumaga confirmatory to with the reproduction number. Yung reproduction number naman, yun yung average number of transmissions. So pag greater than 1, ibig sabihin, dumadami yung hawaan. Pag less than 1, kumukonti. And ngayon, 0.93, kumukonti yung hawaan. And that's why nakakita rin tayo ng negative growth rate pagbaba ng number of cases sa NCR.
Yung bang number of tests, is that constant, Dr. Guido? Halimbawa sa NCR, meron ba kayong natatrack na record at saka consistent ba yung number or is it increasing number? Kasi kahit nasabihin natin, positivity rate went down. Pero yung base, malaki din. Therefore, the positivity rate, whether the rate goes down, but the result will still be high. Consistent ba yung base na yan? Or bumabagsak o tumataas ba yan? We do not know, Dr. Guido.
Those are good points, Senator. And actually, consistent yung base. We're averaging almost close to 30,000 tests per day. Although ideally, it's a surge situation. Dapat nagsiscale up tayo ng testing. Dapat nadadagdagan yung testing. Kasi pag sobrang taas ng positivity rate, there's a risk na, or there is a chance na may mga hindi tayo natetest dahil kulang yung test natin. Pero since bumababa yung positivity rate on a consistent base number, so medyo pareho pa rin yung number of tests natin, it means na nag-improve talaga yung trend.
Well, precisely, that is the challenge. So what is the ideal test that have to be conducted? For example, in NCR, ilan ba talaga ang dapat matest among the population para that will give us confidence that the number of cases is really going down? Kasi kung kakaunti lang ang natetest, siyempre, ang magiging result, when you multiply it, kung ilan ang nag-test positive, pero kakaunti naman yung natetest, that will not give us an accurate data or statistics for additional planning of new strategies or approaches. Hindi
ba? Yes, tama yan, Senator. That's correct. Yung ideal number of tests actually nakadependent sa number of cases na nakikita natin. Ang goal kasi natin per World Health Organization guidelines, nasa less than 5% yung positivity rate natin. And this was in fact what we had several months ago. Noong January, for example, noong stable yung trend natin, we were averaging 400 cases per day. Nasa 4% yung positivity rate natin. It means na sufficient yung natetest natin kasi konti lang nagpa-positive relative to the test. Ngayon, pag nagkaroon ng surge situation, naging 25%, dapat ma-increase natin yung testing natin para maging at least or at most sana mga 10% positivity rate. Kumbaga, we have to, para mangyari yun, we have to, yung 30,000 tests natin, ma-scale up natin to around 75,000 tests per day. So kumbaga, nakadepend siya sa surge. Kasi kung wala naman surge, kung konti lang nagpa-positive, hindi naman natin kailangan dagdagan na yung testing natin.
But of course, Dr. Guido, we all know that the asymptomatic, wala nga symptoms. So people do not know. If they are not tested, they will not be part of the positivity rate. The base will be small. But I was talking with a member of Congress, if I'm not mistaken, the head of the Committee on Health of the House, Congresswoman Tan, Angelina Tan, Helen Tan, that our test, the test is inadequate, no? I mean, that is one thing that is lacking to really isolate those who are positive from those who are negative, and that is a part of the strategy. I just would like to point that out because yung positivity rate, then you will pagka nakuha nyo na based on statistics which is given, kung sinasabing bumababa nga from 25 bumaba sa 20 now 19, it can give us an illusion if there is not enough test. That's just the thing that I'd like to mention, that there seems to be that lack in our overall implementation of the testing strategy. But anyway, kung ang magagawa lang naman ng Okta Research is kung ano yung data na binigay sa inyo ng nakita nyo sa Department of Health, then you make your calculation and your projection. But what do you think, Dr. Guido? Should it increase to 100,000, 250,000 tests nationwide so that we can have an accurate measure of where we are?
Yes, Senator, like we mentioned, right, currently at least 75,000 standing testing sa NCR alone. So nationwide,
alone.
Yeah. So nationwide, siguro nga mga 150,000 would be a starting point. Ibig sabihin capacity lang naman yan. Pag wala namang surge, we can decrease the number of tests. Pero sana yung capacity, kasi what we saw during the surge, hindi nag-increase yung testing. It was stable at around 30,000. Kaya nga, as you are correct, na pag hindi tayo nakapag-test, hindi natin nalalaman kung sino yung mga possibly asymptomatic. Mm-hmm. And it also goes hand in hand with our contact tracing. Kasi sa contact tracing natin na-identify sino yung mga possibly exposed. And even if asymptomatic sila, then pwede sila ma-isolate na agad and prevent them from infecting other people. Kasi important yan in reducing yung reproduction number. Kasi yung sinasabi natin, reproduction number of one, may isang tao, may isang nahahawaan. If we can isolate them quickly, pwedeng wala na sila mahahawaan before once they start showing symptoms. So you're correct there, Senator. We can only work with the data. Pero ideally nga, in a surge situation, dapat kaya natin i-increase yung testing natin. And 150,000 tests per per day sa buong Philippines would be a good number na medyo ano siya, it would accommodate for possible surges. Kunyari, may mangyari pa ulit tayong surge sa future.
Well, of course, going back to the strategy, it's test, isolate, trace, and treat. Ngayon, let's go to the last part, treatment. Sa hospital, hospitalization rate ba, are we now in a better situation, Dr. Guido, based on what you have gathered in terms of those people needing hospitalization? Is our hospital system already able to accommodate those who need hospitalization?
Well, that's another important aspect ng surge. And although nag-improve din trend natin, and those are positive news, siyempre, we welcome naman positive news. The reality is puno pa rin yung hospitals natin, and they will still be full for the next few weeks possibly. Kasi while we still get mga 4,000 cases per day sa NCR or 3,000 cases per day, marami pa rin yan. And 10% of the daily cases, yung 3,000, 10% of those mga 300 will require hospitalization based on yung data natin. So maraming mangangailangan ng hospital. So we will not get immediate reprieve sa ating hospital system. And the other aspect is yung nakita ng isa naming colleague, si Father Nicanor, he did hospital modeling. Ang isang bottleneck natin is because we don't have enough nurses right now. So we can increase yung number of beds natin. We even added ICUs. Pero yung pag-scale up ng nurses natin, ng healthcare workers, medyo hirap tayo. And that's one of the most important factors na dapat ma-scale up natin. We can add beds, pero hindi tayo nakapagdagdag ng enough nurses to accommodate for the increase in cases.
Ano yung tinatawag na critical level na sa hospital system? Is it 70 or 80%? 80%.
It's 70%, Senator. And right now, nasa 70% pa rin tayo sa ICUs, sa NCR. Sa hospital beds, nasa 60%. Pero, you know, anecdotally, what we hear from the ground is, from the hospitals, from doctors, is puno pa rin more or less yung mga hospitals nila. And that's why they are requesting an extension of the MECQ because hindi pa rin sila nagkakaroon ng reprieve sa hospitals.
Well, maraming salamat sa iyo, Dr. Guido David. Maganda at malaki ang role na ginagawa ninyo upang paalam sa ating mga kababayan kung ano talaga ang statistics, number of cases, ano yung projection. Oh, last question, pahabol na lang. Given the trend of less than 1% reproduction number and positivity rate of 19%, what do you see? Will we extend MECQ after April 30?
Well, of course, that's a decision for the national government. Pero yeah, what we're seeing is mataas pa rin yung hospitalization. So maganda yung trend na nag-improve. And you know, we want to sustain yung downward trend. And as you mentioned, may uncertainty pa rin dito, even though we're seeing a downward trend based on the data, may uncertainty because the positivity rate is still high. It means na yung we're maybe not testing enough pa rin. Our contact tracing system is, yung efficiency niya bumaba pa. I mean, bumaba compared to the pre-surge. And, you know, sometimes it's good to, ano, to parang re-evaluate muna yung nangyayari sa NCR, sa trends, before we make hasty decisions kasi pwedeng masayang yung 2 weeks na ECQ natin if we have another surge na mangyari because we relax too quickly. Hindi naman natin pinipicrude yung pag-relax ng interventions. We can do so gradually. You know, one possibility is we could stay in MECQ, pero you know, we add some capacities. Maybe not increase yung public transportation capacity kasi important yan. And yung indoor dining is also important kasi it's a source for transmissions. Pero for example, I mean, it's possible now maybe they could add 10% to churches capacity I mean, from 10 to 20%. So those are some options that the government can take. Pero yung pag-relax too quickly, I think it should be evaluated carefully. Dapat kasi calibrated yung ano natin, yung response natin and yung implementation ng measures.
Okay. Maraming salamat, Dr. Guido David ng Octa Research. So abangan na susunod na kabanata as we get nearer to April 30. Thank you so much, Dr. David.
Thank you, Senator. Good morning.